I'm not big on speeches. I've always believed that the role of the bartender is to shut up and listen. And by that measure, Gabe was the worst bartender I've ever known.
I never issued a speeding ticket to someone on a bicycle before, till he came along.
He cared so much about my admissions essay. Even though he probably couldn't spell admissions or essay.
He booked my band to play the Lantern. All the way from Seattle to pretty much right where I'm standing.
I can recall 14 specific instances where Gabe said something that made me laugh. The first was 2 years ago.
So, long story short, instead of a ticket, I ended up buying him a beer.
Gabe stood like 3 feet away, grinning like a doofus at us. I'm sure there were more people, but I only remember him.
And then he said, I know, that's why the K is silent. Then the fifth time.
He cared about everyone.
He was the kind of guy you wanted to be around.
He was a world-class bullshitter.
He was my best friend.
All I want to say about Gabe is he came into this bar as a stranger, but he left it as family. Guess that's that then. What happened to Gabe was a senseless, tragic accident. And I just wish
that... It wasn't an accident.
Son, now is not the time.
Gabe called the mine. I gave him my sat phone to be sure he could get through. They fucked up. And now... Now Gabe's dead.
That was my shift. If anyone had called, it would have gone through me. Nobody called.
You're lying. In front of Gabe's own fucking sister, Alex heard the whole thing.
He's right. I was there when Gabe made the call.
I'd like to hear what you have to say about that, Mac.
I'm not saying anything. Just, I didn't get a call. Draw your own conclusions.
All right, folks. This is an ongoing investigation.
How about we review the sequence of events,
Well, son.
When I saw you at the record store, you seemed pretty eager to find Gabe. Remember why? Another fight with Riley, maybe?
No, I don't have to take this.
Just saying, pretty wild that you come stumbling out of Gabe's apartment with your face all fucked up.
Ryan.
And just a couple hours later, you just so happened to miss the call that would have saved his life.
Look, I told you there was no call to miss. Okay, maybe the call got dropped. Or shit, I mean, it's not like Gabe was Mr. Reliable all the time.
Watch your mouth, Mac.
Ryan, that's enough. Now, I'm just as eager as you to understand all this, son, but there was a time—
Bullshit, Dad. This little weasel's calling Gabe a liar at his own fucking wake.
No, I am just telling you—
Mac, I swear, if you say there was no call one more fucking time—
Stop it! Stop it now! This is not the time or place. We're all here for Gabe. Okay, Ryan?
Sure, I'm sorry. It's not... I'm just... I'm not the one who killed him.
Aren't you, though?
What the fuck did you just say?
Ryan, back off.
Oh, hell.
I'm just saying.
I thought I heard that you
Mac,
were the one—
you shut the hell up.
No. No, go ahead. You got something to say, Mac? Let's fucking hear
Come
it.
Come on, guys. Don't make me intervene.
All right! Fine! As long as we're tossing around accusations, way I hear it, you're the guy who cut the rope. Why not
That's
you?
That's it. Wake's over. Everyone out.
Alex?
Hey, fuck those guys.
Yeah.
Are you okay?
God, no. I'm a fucking wreck.
It's not your job to keep it together.
Thanks. Do you... it's messy, but do you want to come in?
Sure. You play guitar?
Yeah, well, sorta. I used to.
Cool. Gabe would try to pop wheelies outside the record store to make me laugh. Never worked. Till he wiped out. That was hilarious. Gabe really wanted to do the LARP for Ethan. But by the end of it, he was more jazzed about it than anybody.
Wish I could have seen it.
Yeah. We took this a year ago. No way. I can't.
What?
You actually kept it. just need a minute.
Yeah, no problem. Calm down, Alex. You're fine. You're fine. Whatever that bottle made her think of, it really messed her up. I wonder if I could help her the same way I helped Ethan. I need to feel her sadness to figure out how to help her. Charlotte's sculpture. I wonder how she's really holding up. Love that Gabe was going to be part of a LARP. Would have been fun to see. Getting dressed shouldn't be so hard. And yet. Hey, Shushu. Thanks for sticking around. Find out what's really going on with Steph.
What are they called again?
Don't shit on my yard! They're amazing! Their guitarist has one arm.
Badass.
Dude, give it up. I already booked a bus ticket.
Wait, hear me out. One more game. If I win, you have to stay. If you win, I'll cover the ticket.
You just lost $50.
Steph?
Sorry. This is so embarrassing.
Ladies and gentlemen, presenting your new foosball champion, Gabe Chen.
Oh, you're the worst! Can't believe I have to stay in this stupid town.
I think we both know you could have beat me if you really wanted to. So you're welcome.
Bullshit.
Her sadness is so strong. I hope I can help.
Wait, hear me out. One more game. If I win, you have to stay. Here's to your new job at the station.
Oh, didn't I tell you? I'm not taking it. I move to Denver next week.
You what? Fucking overpowered blue meteor.
Aww. Is your controller broken too?
We're playing until I win.
Then I'll be crashing here tonight.
I think I know enough to help her now. Still can't believe he's gone.
Yeah. He's the whole reason I'm still... I'm sorry, Alex. Don't mind me.
How about a quick match?
Did Gabe tell you we played?
I just had a hunch.
Yeah? Well, you're right. I don't really think it's a great time. Fine.
First to 5 points?
If you say so.
So, how often did you and Gabe play?
It was one of our favorite games.
You must be pretty good then.
Mm-hmm.
You were in a band, right?
Yeah.
What'd you play?
Drums.
How long did you play with them?
Too long.
Gotcha.
Yep. Big shocker.
Oh, hey, at least you played your best.
I mean, that obviously wasn't my best.
No, I get it. I mean, this is a tough game. It requires skill, timing, and the will to be a champion.
Oh, is that how it is?
Okay. Joking aside, playing this stupid game with you is exactly what I need right now.
You're on.
Woo! Foosball champion! Foosball champion!
Goddamn!
Shit, family!
Oh!
Good game.
Thanks, Alex. I'm really glad you talked me into it. It was a lot of fun.
Of course.
Crazy that you knew exactly what would cheer me up.
Don't give me too much credit. I'm the one who really needed it.
So, what are you gonna do now?
What do you mean?
That shit with Mac, he's clearly lying, right?
I'm not sure what Mac's deal is. His story doesn't add up.
Yeah.
I do know that I need to find out exactly what happened that night. For myself and for Gabe.
I've got your back. No matter what.
Thank you. Means a lot.
I should head back to work.
Cool.
Bye.
Bye. Thanks, Jed.
Oh, hey, kid, you don't have to do that.
Too late.
Wanted to apologize. For all of us. We're all grieving, but that's no excuse. It was your brother's wake, and you both deserve better than listening to a bunch of fools squabble.
I appreciate it. That was pretty rough. Although it's hard to imagine a good version of your dead brother's wake.
No, there's no good version. Just all of us trying to get through it together the best we can. It wasn't the first wake held in this old building. I doubt it'll be the last. Anyway, if there's anything I can do, just let me know.
I need to talk to Mac. I know he's lying. I just don't know why. Any idea where I can find him?
Well, he helps out Eleanor at the flower shop. That'd be the place to start.
Thanks.
I feel like I should warn you, though. You might not get the kind of closure you're looking for. If you get any at all. Just don't pin all your hopes on Mac Loudon.
Thanks for looking out for me, but what else am I supposed to do?
I wish I had an answer for you. But if you get a chance before you go all Dirty Harry, swing by the dispensary. Charlotte wants to see you. And one more thing. I've been meaning to give you this for the last few days, but I didn't want to disturb you up there. It'll get you through that door and the one upstairs. This is your home now, for as long as you'd like.
What about rent? I don't want to be a freeloader.
Don't worry about that for right now. We'll work out a way for you to earn your keep when the time comes.
Thank you.
Give him hell.
I have no idea what to even say to him. I should put something here. It's the least I can do. Maybe I can find something upstairs to put on the memory table. Wonder what I can find up here to add to Gabe's memory table. You're coming downstairs. Glad I have something to add to Gabe's table. I bet Gabe would be up here a lot if he wasn't the one taking the pictures.
Hopefully, things around here can settle down again.
Yeah, that'd be good. RM and TB. I wonder who they were. Okay, Jed said I might find Mac in the flower shop, but I have time to swing by the dispensary if I want.
Oh, you heard about the accident. Was it on the news? No.
Might be a good time to check out the dispensary. Jed said Charlotte wants to talk to me.
Sure.
Oh, sorry.
We met briefly. You're Gabe Chen's sister, right?
Alex, yeah.
I didn't know him well, but I could tell he had a big heart. I'm so sorry for your loss.
Charlotte?
Alex, hey.
Jed said you wanted to see me?
I just wanted to see how you were doing.
I'm okay. Keeping my chin up.
Sometimes that's all you can do.
How about you? Can't even imagine what you're going through.
Honestly, I'm really trying to keep it together for Ethan. He's hurting.
Is he all right?
He practically just lost a father. But he's shutting me out. He's never done that before. Not when it mattered.
Stay strong. You'll get through the hard parts. Both of you.
Easier said than done, huh?
Yeah. No shit.
I can't get over the feeling that the one person who could help me deal with the aftermath of Gabe's death is Gabe.
What is this?
An affidavit from Typhon. If I sign, I'm agreeing not to press charges in exchange for a payment. A big one.
How big are we talking?
It's send Ethan to college big.
Shit. Are you gonna sign it?
I don't know. I'm
trying to put Ethan first, but... what would you do? Do you think it would be a betrayal of Gabe? I don't think you should sign it. I'm sorry. I know it's hard, but you can't let Typhon buy you off. Gabe made that call, and I'm gonna prove it. I need some time.
Thanks for being honest.
If they're willing to pay Charlotte to keep quiet, they're definitely hiding something.
I'm gonna figure out why Mac's lying. I'm always here for you, if you need anything.
Thanks. Back at you. And he did it all with one rusty saw and a bottle of gin. Impressive.
In the Dominican, they're said to house the spirits of gods. Mostly, I just like how it looks.
It's really cool. Charlotte's dedication to her art is so inspiring. Still need to check the flower shop for Mac.
It's fine. I love being on hold. I love this song. Finally, cancel AAA membership.
Eleanor?
Oh!
Sorry.
No need to apologize. How are you, dear?
Oh. I'm, I'm okay, I guess. Taking it one moment at a time.
It's the best way to be.
Is Mac here?
Oh, he was helping me not too long ago. I think he just left. Can't have gotten too far.
Got it. Thanks.
Now, what was I?
She looks terrified. I can't leave her like this.
Okay. Time to figure out why she's afraid.
All my memories, all my are, memories fading. Are fading. I feel broken. The doctor said I had more time, but everything is becoming so out of order. If they know about my condition, they'll make me close this place. Riley finds out. She can't find out.
Thank you, dear. I'll get started on it right away. Just come by with the check whenever you're free.
Holy shit. Just that she forgot what she was doing. She's afraid she's forgetting everything. But how can I help her? Forget what you were working on?
Could say I'm having a bit of a senior moment.
Well, maybe I can help. Seems like you have a lot going on today. I could help you retrace your steps.
Oh, I don't want to keep you.
Hey, I want to help. Okay, what would Eleanor have done first? Did you trim these flowers today?
Don't remember.
You must have flipped the sign to open.
I always flip it first thing when I come in, and then I open my mail. Something must have distracted me.
Better. We can do this. Could a phone call have distracted you?
Yes. I got a call first thing in the morning. But I can't think who it was.
Maybe we can find something to remind you. Could it have been Riley who called?
I think that's right. She called to tell me about a new order. Goodness. What was the order for?
Rush order. This must be what Riley came in for. I think that order might have been for these lilies.
Of course. Riley helped me pick them up before she left.
Now we just have to figure out who ordered them. The check for the lilies would be in here, right? That could tell us who bought them.
It should.
Mr. Jedediah Lucan, huh. Looks like the lilies are for Jed.
That's right. Riley dropped off an order for Jed.
I knew you'd figure it out.
I couldn't have done it without you. Seriously, Alex, you're a godsend. Jed must be hosting some event. I wonder why he wants lilies, though. They're traditionally for funerals.
God. She doesn't remember. You know Jed. Probably doesn't know the difference between a lily and a tulip.
Don't sell him short. He's more clever than he seems. Thanks again for your help. Don't be a stranger.
I won't. Promise. I hope it's good news. Okay, this shirt rules. Is it Riley's?
Raisin Harder. It's surprisingly addictive.
You... Eleanor said Mac is nearby. I don't see him here. Maybe at the bridge? Hey, Riley. Alex.
Hey.
That fight Mac had with Gabe over your secret meetings. They were about you applying to college, right?
Yeah. Ever since the first time Mac lost his shit in front of them, Gabe and Charlotte had tried to get me to end things with him. And after all this, I can see that they were right.
Do you think he could have ignored Gabe's call? I mean, do you think he's capable of that?
I don't want to believe that, but... Sorry, I'm really not ready to talk about it.
Are you sure? Sometimes talking about it can help you sort it all out.
I'm just not there yet.
You and Eleanor seem close.
She's taken care of me ever since I was little. I never really knew my mom, but she's always been there for me.
What does she think about you going away to school?
She's thrilled. I think she just wants me to end up happy.
That's really sweet.
She's the most selfless person I know.
I know having you work with her in the shop has meant the world.
Yeah. To both of us.
I know you and Gabe were close. How are you doing?
I miss him. So much. He was like an older brother to me.
I'm glad he had you.
Thank you, Alex. Really.
I gotta run. There's some stuff I need to do.
Okay.
I don't want to push Riley, but I need to know more about Mac. How do I get her to open up?
If he's innocent, why is he acting like this?
Acting like what? Maybe I can get her to tell me. Do you want to talk about Mac? Yeah, I get it. It's just, if he didn't do anything wrong, why is he acting like he has something to hide?
He asked me to leave Haven with him.
What?
Right after the wake. He wouldn't tell me why. But he just looked so guilty. I told him I had to think about it, but... Alex, I'm scared he did something horrible.
Riley, thank you for telling me.
You deserve the truth.
I gotta run. There's some stuff I need to do.
Okay. We'll talk soon?
Yeah. Whenever you want. Mac trying to skip town is sketchy as shit. I bet I could use that to stoke his fear. I should make sure there's nothing else I want to do before I confront Mac. What Riley told me might do it, but I should make sure there isn't anything I still want to do around town first. Okay, let's do this.
I got Riley to tell me about your plans to leave town. That's not something innocent people do.
God. It's not... I didn't do anything. Just fuck off! Leave me alone!
Thank you.
deal with Mac when I get to him. For now, I need to learn everything I can.
Typhon's always watching. They run this whole town.
Mac feels like everyone's staring at him.
Everyone thinks I killed him. They all hate me. It's not fair. I didn't do anything wrong.
It should have been you instead.
Alex?
No! What the hell? There are people out there! No, I told you to call it off.
I saw the way they looked at me at the wake. They all think I let him die.
I know why you're lying.
Typhon's forcing you to deny the call. I know you tried to stop it. They fucked up, not you. Stop lying for them!
You don't get it. This wasn't some accident. I told them you were down there, and they detonated anyway.
On purpose? Why?
I don't know. I swear. And then I get a message telling me to deny there was ever a call. You gotta believe me. Gabe and I, we didn't get along, but I didn't want him dead. And now Typhon's watching me. I mean, my girlfriend, she thinks I'm a murderer. My neighbors all hate me. I mean, what the fuck am I supposed to do?
I think I can calm him down. But does he deserve it? All right, Mac. Come on. You gotta calm down, okay? Dude, stay with me. I know what it's like to be doubted. To have everyone think the worst of you. But the truth will come out. I'll make sure of it.
But Typhon...
If Typhon comes after you, they're gonna have to get through me too, okay?
Thanks. I actually feel a little better.
Yeah, well, you learn a thing or two hanging out with shrinks your whole life.
So, what are you gonna do now?
Don't leave Haven. I'm gonna get to the truth. Hey. Yeah, it's... Can we talk? Where are you? Okay. You were right. About Typhon, about Mac.
Alex.
Mac got the call.
How do you know that?
He got the call and he lied about it.
Doesn't matter.
Someone is putting pressure on him to keep quiet. Someone from the mine and...
It doesn't matter! I keep... coming here and playing it back, but it always ends the same.
Ryan,
he's dead. He's really dead, Alex. It was my fault. My job is to keep people safe. And I failed.
Ryan. I owe you my life.
She's wrong. I let her cross that log. I put Gabe in harm's way. I'm not a hero. I'm a coward. Worse than worthless.
I know what it's like to feel worthless and helpless. But we saved Ethan. And you saved me.
It doesn't matter. Gabe's dead because of me. Gabe, I'm so sorry.
Gabe loved you, Ryan. He would forgive you. You know that. You're not alone.
In a gorilla suit? Does he also jump off of the cliff and into the pool?
No. He chases a guy in a banana suit. That guy jumps off the cliff and into the pool.
Okay, I'm sorry. This is a Mexican restaurant?
Nominally. The food is, terrible. But it's Gabe's favorite place. I tell you, he's the oldest 12-year-old I know. Can I ask you something?
Of course.
You came up here to tell me that I was right about Mac. About him getting the call.
How did you know?
There's something you should know about me. And it's gonna be easier to show you than to explain it. This is gonna seem sort of weird at first, then really weird. Do you trust me? Okay. Think of something that just scares the shit out of you. Really focus until you feel it. Mac, Typhon, all of it. You're afraid you won't know how to handle it without Gabe.
Never knew anyone so good at getting into and out of trouble. Oh, man, this one time.
Whatever it is you're thinking about right now, don't stop, okay? Keep going.
Okay.
What emotion is this? Must be a good memory. I wonder if I can piece it together.
How deep you think?
Deeper than that. The Royal Canadian Mounted Police can spot a goose grave at 100 paces.
The Mounties? Oh, come on, man.
I'm sorry.
How long were you going to let me dig?
Well, I wasn't going to stop you.
Oh, that's a lot of blood, huh?
Gabe, this is serious. Killing a Canadian goose is a violation of international law.
Shut up. It is not.
They're Canadian geese, Gabe. Property of the Crown.
The Crown of...
Property of the Crown, Gabe.
What do we do?
Gabe. Goose.
I see it. It'll move.
It's not moving.
It'll move.
Gabe!
So, did you finish burying the goose or not? Okay, also, property of the crown? Really?
Well... they are technically protected under the Migratory Bird Treaty Act.
So, I guess I have this power. I can see other people's emotions. They show up like an aura, and if I get too close, I feel what they feel. As if I was feeling it myself. And when I focus, I can even understand why they're feeling it.
And that's what you just did with me? Whew. Some kind of power. No kidding.
It's only ever been the bad emotions before, but that was pure joy.
Who else knows?
I've never told anyone until now. And that's how I know Mac's terrified of Typhon. He reported Gabe's call, and they ignored it. Now they're putting pressure on him to toe the line.
Okay, but why?
I don't know yet. Someone made the decision to let the blast go off. Seems like finding out who would be a good start.
So, you're going after Typhon? You'll need help.
You don't have to.
You're stuck with me now. I guess.
Yeah. Thanks. Thank you.
No. Thank you.
This one's for you, Gabe. I miss you.
Speak this morning. I couldn't. Hearing everyone talk about him, about the life he had here with all of you, I lost the chance to have that. But even though I only had one day with him, he changed my life. Said, I didn't know if I belonged here. He told me that home isn't something you find. It's something you build.
I won't hold on to this place without you.
love you, Gabe.
Say goodbye. How do I say I miss all the ways you made me smile? How do I show